say something that that I wanted to say a few days ago at this meeting, even though I'm not necessarily a part of it, in a way that I am. It's more under the nesting part of it. And I say that for this reason. There's a book out, it's called Rise of the Creative Class. I would suggest that all y'all remember this book, try to write it down. There's city managers all over the country that have looked at this. And what they did is they did the evaluations by Richard Florida, where if you are involved in a city that encouraged the creative people and the artists and the thinkers and the people that are coming in and you welcome a little bit like what Monte was saying here, the people will come. They're going to come. I have done nothing magic here. I give you my word, I have not. I have only fulfilled part of a dream that I wanted to develop 10 to 15 years ago as a sculptor and open this up. But I'm going to make a prediction here. It's very easy for me to do. It's not a Nostradamus moment. But I'm going to put some heat where the heat needs to be, and I'm going to be quiet where it needs to be quiet. But I'm working hard with Rodney and some other people to get a sidewalk, for example, from this end of the street to the other end of the street. Beautiful city hurricane lanterns that flicker at night. I'm going to build a beautiful wall around this for this cafe. And on the other side of this tree line, where we're also going to have beekeeping as well, in the urban gardening area, there are 250 parking spots that I think is Area 52 of the United States. Nobody knows this parking lot exists. Don't tell anybody. I won't. And so, but this is going to be great for the people that are going to be able to come and go. Now, I say that for this reason as well. I will do this if I want to. And I will go further beyond this. And I say that in front of everybody here. Because if you don't do it, I'm going to do it. You don't have that much longer. I do want to lobby to get these top lofts. I know they need fire sprinklers. We're not going to get into that. I understand that. I was up there and I created the sculpture of Radio. I'm going to make a point to say that the radio for the movie Radio. Down below there, I created a $2.9 million sculpture of Ray Charles in Albany, Georgia. Below that and upstairs, I'm sorry, everybody left me alone. And they knew I was there. I behaved. I made sure that it was reasonably fire safe. And I get in trouble for it. I really, frankly, don't care. I did some beautiful artwork up there. And I did the True Kathy sculptures there. There's nine of those that stay here. And I want you to imagine this. Above PJ's in Rusty Strong's building, the building where Red's was, the Jim Chaffin building, and the building on the square I came in for somebody like me. And I'm not going to pitch and raise hell or anything like that, although I can. But I want to do it with success and to give y'all something to nest your business. I don't know what all your businesses are, but I assure you that I can go to the property owners of those properties and say, give me those upstairs floors. Give me your empty space, even on the square. And I'll stick artists in there at a cheap rate to pay the taxes and to pay the power bills. And I won't rent all of them out. But I'm going to leave some of them available because of the other business that will move in when they find out the artists are out on that square at 3 o'clock in the morning. Not raising cane, not doing things they shouldn't be doing, creating art, painting, sculpting, glass blowing, playing their guitars. I got news for you. You build a nest like that on that square and with this art center and the things that are going south in the square, this will be a tourist. We already have the movie industry. We have their notice. We have their recognition right now. We have it. This can be an art town. And if it does, Katie bars doors on real estate properties. I'm not kidding you. You all know this. And I'm not in the real estate business, but I am a business person as well as a sculptor. So there's people that have come all around here, like I said, Ant Farm, that just bought property here. They're telling other people that they bought property here as well. And now there are more walkers and joggers coming down this road. It's amazing, folks, the life that's going to happen here. And it's not me. I'm just one person. But look at all this. This is what's really going to happen. we get this available and we get some things eased up a little bit within reason and measurable increments of success and bring the creative class up there, that's what all y'all are talking about. But I just don't know if you know that. Bring it in and they'll come. And then you build on what this nest is that people like me can build. Just ridiculous people like me. So anyway, thank you for that.